Big Clan up against them in their boot camp of their very own design, Berlin International Gaming. You'll never guess where their boot camp is. Simple, actually. Up on a project long, and it's just him. Simple versus the world. They swing out loudly. If he can get a couple of heads, that's a dream. But a mobile target does keep him honest. And Boomich, he's going to have to get the hell out of dodge here. He's so blind. Shots to the back aren't easy. Gade chips away at him, and they've got full long control. But look how quick Electronic is behind him.
Oof, this was what Yanko was talking about, the second star, the more experienced member. Electronic locking the door here. So Big will be condemned to long.
What are Perfecto and Bit doing? Why are they not going ramp? Do they want to be short side?
I think they're still worried about a bit of a dark lurk, right? They're not 100% sure. Positive exactly where all of the four T's are. So going to be crossing now in towards A. The smokes will bloom. Boomich will communicate that, but are they going to wait for Electronic to flank here? Because this is very silent, almost on the gap. Boomich spots something.
Yeah, he's got a nade as well. I don't know how prominent that will be. Electronic's trying to time this to perfect.
Yeah, double nades.
Oh, really? Yeah, one sailing through the air from Boomich, and there's the second. Down it goes, but the bomb now planted. Electronic trying to time this right. Tabson's looked away. He's averted his gaze. Contact from short. They're counting the numbers. They can count three. And from behind, Electronic is the four.
Oh, needed that.
He did need that, and it's given him a chance. Tabson's very low. He can clutch this up. Bomb ticking, hard shots to hit, and now already, ouch, those bullets connect quickly. It's three from Perfecto, who has been a bit of a sleeper OP for NaVi.
Yeah, we were in the car on the way in today thinking about, okay, yeah, so Simple's been Simple,
yep.
Bit's been headshotting everybody, yep. Electronic's had some good days online, Boomich has been entry fragging, and Perfecto's been clutching.
Well, Boomich was carrying, I swear, the whole Mirage half, we didn't really get to talk about anyone but Boomich because it was just a double kill and forcing saves out of him as a leader with some incredible impact. We'll see Simple's tested here, but it's his team that actually converted the pistol after a rather intense affair.
I'm curious if this is a sign of things to come, having the utility when they go for a long play, because we've seen Big in the last couple of days do a lot of that. So if NaVi have come prepared, they might see them hold on to a couple of extra HEs or mollies to do exactly that in future rounds. Well, and the other man who's had some tendencies here for Big is Sirison. They park this guy very Jame-esque mid-doors to deal with rotations. So NaVi are going to have to solve that puzzle too.
Why does Big Clan... Don't want to let this one slip away. And Tabson's prioritized utility, so I'll be intrigued to see how he plans to utilize that appropriately.
Well, they're looking set for a B hit here. Going to spot on the Jiggle. Uh-oh. Perfecto.
Yeah, bit panic stations does drop the incendiary. So there you go. They've pulled some CT utility out.
Nothing gained, but nothing lost, I suppose. Siphoning through a little bit of utility if they want to return to that B bomb site late. Tizian has space towards long, and he's done a great job, Tizian, in a couple of these games here, finding space and impact for the team. Really having to fill that void that Zantara's has left, everybody needing to step up a little bit more. And as we return to long, Sirison, Tabson, and Kito will join him. Gade to go late short, and that's exactly where NaVi want control. They're going to push on into Gade's realm any moment here.
It's just like a kind of a trade. You want long? Fine, but we want your short. Gade's the one to deny that pursuit of control. 30 seconds, they're pushing for it. Lots of util dumped here, but they're heading into way. Boomich catches Gade. Now they can relax and play from short. Nothing to report. Simple, a dink into Tizian, but now the site is theirs. Electronic, a little bit of a curveball. The plant is safe, though, and so he bides his time.
No kit for this.
Looking convincing, actually. Big Clan, a lot of the hard work done, but they do have to defend their honor now. This crossfire established this and hunting desperately. Ooh. For that scout frag, and there it is. Boomich on his bottom. Losing players. Kito down. They're closing the gap. A 10-second defuse required, and now Sirs and Scout already hitting another great shot.
Perfecto needs to kill
him,
like,
push
right
him,
now.
Like now. Yeah, I don't think he's got the time. Sirs knows. I don't think Perfecto's got the run in him.
Yeah, can't get back there in time, surely. Unless Simple had a kill. I don't think he did. Yeah, not a chance in the world there, Perfecto. So Big, they bounce back immediately here. Just up long. Okay, game on. 1-1, we sit. I'm sure NaVi want to force Maya back immediately here. And with everybody from Big going down, it means, well, they will have enough money to get the AKs out. The utility will be there as well, but they're not working on the bank going forward just yet.
They were threatening for a while, Sis, and there really was the difference maker. That shot onto Electronic. Don't forget how weird that 1v2 gets if he doesn't immediately neutralize that bomb defuse threat.
Yeah. What's... Perfecto doesn't have a... Okay, there we go. He got the M4 back. He left spawn without it, so we'll...
Oh, he's already out, and so many bodies on long. Gade's doing his best, trifling with some Deegs and SMGs. They're really trying to isolate him. Electronic will finish the job. And
How's he got that?
Takes another head. Snaps onto Keto before he falls, and he's managed to give Na'Vi a man advantage by he. I'm referring to the boom, it's Deeg.
Okay, well, they have the number advantage right now.
I don't envy Electronic's position, though. It's not easy to have impact from here when the smokes arrive. And he'll throw out one of his own. I'm interested. Will that slow him down? Bit sus on that smoke.
Well, another one as well. Simple does that with the AWP here. Dropped it now on this low buy. And Tabson, curiously, boosted over the smoke. There is a timer on this.
Yeah, there is. And I believe Electronic could be a bit of a threat. He'll
Time's
hear
up.
The sound cue. And these remaining three members of Big Clan are now under the scrutiny of Na'Vi's return, but force buy. Tabson does have a lot to do, and he's not going to get to do anything. Everyone's Deagle connects. Let's see if Perfecto can get the last. And he can. A team ace. Everybody contributes from Natus Vincere. And it looks like Force by Wars are fully underway.
Saracen's definitely on so far, right? We've seen a couple of banger scout shots out of him, and that's always a good sign. If you don't see him with the AWP, you tend to see him with the scout and doing, well, just as much damage. Not able to get enough frags in that one-on-four scenario. And a big one to keep pushing the issue. Bigger one of these teams who you'll see them in conservative stances from time to time where they could go for a force and then the eco in the next. If they lose, they tend to go for two like partials with some upgraded pistols so that they can have all the goodies for the gun round. But when the economy hasn't been built yet, we see them wanting to go toe-to-toe and just have a bit of a slog out early. Yeah. Some back into the scout. Deagles for most. And there's an opening. Boomich taking this round into his own hands. Long lockdown. Tizian removed and four to find.
Is Boomich going to keep that form up from the previous game?
Wouldn't that be something? If everybody on Na'Vi continues to play at the level we've seen out of them so far, it's so much more of a team, right? And that right there is the key is, well, Perfecto opens the account.
Yeah, I really like the analysis we got out of Yanko and the desk stunner pulling it out of him in the idea of, ooh, close but no cigar for the Tabson project. Bomb's now loose in mid, and I just want to make sure that's not going to fall awry. They are going to commit, it seems. Gade and Keto, flanked by Simple, and it's as easy as that. But yeah, I mean, the fact that Na'Vi are no longer slow starters, the fact that they're performing in the, you know, a replicatable form that we saw over in Iron Cologne, very, very scary signs for anyone in their group.
Yeah, and I think when you consider just the Na'Vi trials and tribulations over the years, there was always the threat of Na'Vi being one of the best teams in the world. They just never had all the parts that they required. Now it feels like they have the parts as far as the members go. And with Blade in his coaching role, they seem to have the correct direction as well.
Agreed.
So it's all come together here.
This is ambitious. Simple knows they're up on the pistols, and so he wants to make this SMG work. $1,200 potentially to be injected into his bank account, and he tracks first. And deals with the second lovely injection of cash for Simple to splash into the following round. He might even get some more here. They might let him off the leash.
Yeah, these Glocks are only going to pepper him away. So not too many dramas for Na'Vi in a round like this. I just want to read out what the ramifications of today's games are, because as we make it to about halfway, we can see, well, at least with some names, who can make it and who can't. So today for Na'Vi, they can qualify if they beat Big, FaZe beat Fnatic, and Mousesports beat EG. So if you're a Na'Vi fan and you're watching right now, later in the day you want to be barracking for FaZe to topple Fnatic. You want Mousesports to topple EG.
Oh, can I just... Fnatic completely up in the air.
Yeah, I think this group, like, FaZe have showed better form than we've expected from them online, at least historically. So that's a positive, but they got pushed last night by EG. So it feels like that matchup against Fnatic, who have been looking pretty good, all things considered, it could be wide open.
It could be. And also just seeing how Alex's Counter-Strike interacts with that of Karrigan. Oi! Patience rewarded, nets him an opening kill. Electronic looking a little relaxed on that swing.
I think the reason they've gone for this is you can see just how much territory was given up towards long here. Simple was just watching from the crossover. So if they expected them to go four out long, which is standard, Saracen would be their part of that pack. So swinging into that AWP, maybe, you know, a little bit of a byproduct of the way that Big like to approach this T side.
Interesting. And I guess that explains how Electronic gets behind them so quickly, because he would go for a little ambitious push like that. This time, of course, no way Jose. He's not going to be locking the door. In fact, far from it. Forced to watch from the cold, as it is this 5v4. A man advantage for Big, and they're fully committed long.
Yeah, keep your eyes on Simple Smoke. We talk about it a lot here. Drops it, normally quite passive to AWP around. You can see it there in his hand, ready to go.
Boomich. Oh, he holds it and holds his nerve for one. Still the man advantage. This is Simple playing around the smoke. And they know what he's up to. Boosting on the box is a death sentence. You have to go wide to play around this smoke, and that's why he can post up and peek as well. Good timing on the incendiary as they boost. That might force them into the sidecar. Positions a threat. A good counter flash. So many bodies in the site. It looks like NaVi have clawed it back. All onto Simple now. Perfecto worked with him to get him to this point, and they have to get across. A great flash should initiate the plant. There's still not a cross charge. And he's hit the first onto Sears, and magnificent shooting. Trajectory gate has to plant in 15 seconds, and Simple.
It's shallow.
Yeah, he fires off a warning shot, though, so Gade will know what he's up to. Hitting the wallbang, he's dead on the money. Gade knows the hunt is coming. Timing is everything on his fight. Precision required from the new addition to Big Clan, and it's a tag down to the USP. Gade will convert. And Simple, a little hard done by there. The box saving the Dane's life.
Nice clutch there by Gade.
Huge.
A necessary one here to keep that AWP alive. Wouldn't have been possible otherwise. And it was pretty brawly, right? Boomich there being a jarring force, and it got that close with Electronic giving up what felt like a freebie, right? So a 5v4 advantage for Big to work with. They convert in the end.
When we brought up Season 13 stats as well from Group C, just it blew my mind and reminded me of what Gambit were up to with their, what was it, 5v4 win percentage was 80-something? Like, you lose that opening frag, you're just going to lose. They'll make sure you lose the rest of those players.
Yeah, that's the thing, right? I think Gambit has kind of filled that void of the percentage Counter-Strike that Astralis left when all these roster changes came in. So Gambit have picked up that torch, and they're definitely running with it. I think NaVi are getting there, but with a bit more flair as the big man himself.
Ooh, he's well aware of what's coming his way. Flash is a bit high. He might be caught out here. Oh, he didn't expect them to be so far forward, and they've already got one. Trying to isolate an aggressive stance out of Perfecto costs him his life, and Keto and Tizian have done a lot there. And NaVi refused to give them control of mid-doors. The smoke to deny.
You kind of want to go B here. You know, Bit is the only B defender, but now Electronic pushing up close doors.
He's got so much to do. So much to do. Gade was ready for him as well. Where is this aggression coming out of NaVi? 60 seconds he walked through that smoke. Gade greets him with a smile. And now it gets a bit weird. So Bit's going to have to be responsible for a lot. Oh,
Boomich has heard him.
Did he?
Yeah, he has. He's heard these steps. Surely he has now. No, maybe he hasn't.
I don't think so. I think Boomich is about to get spanked.
I swear it looked like he heard him there for a second.
It did look like he acknowledged it, yeah.
Okay, well, strange one now. Is Bit left in a 1-on-3? I think this is a big round every day of the week. Bit agrees. We'll have to save. And just some odd timings there. You know, Simple crossing the doors, probably expecting more respect than he got. But Bit will save that AWP.
Will he?
I think that's... Yeah, good point, actually. They might try and chase him here. Tabson's already down towards spawn. Gade is going to be working towards T-spawn. So maybe this doesn't actually stay with NaVi.
Gade's the most promising by a large margin.
Let's see if Gade... wiggle on.
Yeah, but it's far too wise for any of that.
Ooh.
Had to hit that one, and he should be fine.
Should be fine now for sure. Now, I think here one of the things that you have to consider if you are NaVi and you have Simple is that there's no way they're going to be peeking me, but Big have Sirison, so they have a lot of confidence in their AWPer as well. On a map like Dust 2, just the presence of a good AWPer is what keeps CTs kind of on the leash, right? I can't over-peek, I can't get too brave about how I want to approach some of these angles. You either need a flash, you need a little jiggle, you need something.
And a great example of that is watch Simple's T-side, James' T-side. You just witness how quickly it can completely cage a CT side when you know that there's still that AWPing presence patrolling.
Well, here's the AWP on Simple. Now, he needs to find some impact here. Bit saved this for him. Already being called to help Boomich at long right now, so they're going to be boosting him up towards the site. Short, a problem. Long, also an issue. A three-man stack from NaVi over towards B, as they hope that Simple's AWP will push them to that side of the map. But when Big have long control here, we normally see them just press the issue, whether it's quick or slow. They'll take their time. They'll use their superior utility here and their forces to get across. And NaVi, they're calling their bluff on that.
We call this the NaVi dust too, right? Like the all-in long.
That's what they were just doing at Katowice in 2020, right? They were just going long, going long, going long. So if anyone's going to know how to counter it, it should be NaVi. It's just so difficult. Like, without a whole lot of utility, which they have one nade on Perfecto, and they don't even have a flash to pop through the smoke here. The biggest thing that's going to help them is the time.
Okay, well, they're starting to progress, and there's... Eagle for info. He's spotted a whole lot. It seems like it is going to be a very quick cross. Not slowing down. It's a all-in maneuver, and Simple's AWP patrolling. Perfecto's nade has actually finished off the job onto Keto, combined with an AWP tag. So now they know where Simple is. AWPing short. What is he supposed to do now? Because the bomb is going to be planted uncontested. Electronic could try it.
Maybe a little jump. I don't know.
Jumpy P250, but not easy to do. His wallbangs are dead on. Just the angle not going to be rewarded. Have to be straight up on that fight. Simple wants to save this, surely.
Yeah, it could be worth getting out of there now. Oh, they've given another here. They have the number advantage. They're ushering him out of the bomb site. So, Operation Save Simple. They've done a little bit of damage, right? They took away two rifles. I guess that's enough.
Electronic's been dispatched to try and get a little more. Oof. Like, if he could force another rebuy, this a nice snappy Glock. Keeps hold of his AWP.
Getting a bit frisky there. So, bomb is going to go off. The scoreline will be tied up 4-4. And this is good from Big, keeping things level early here. I'm pretty sure, let me double check, as I was having a look at some of the results this morning, I think the last time these two teams went head-to-head on Dust 2, NaVi absolutely rattled them. This was at the Blast Premier Spring Finals. It was Dust 2, and NaVi beat them 16-2. That was Big's pick. So they've already done better than last time round here, Big Clan.
Already.
Already.
Different look out of the German squad so far. So Tizian wants to try and sell the battle for long. Searson typically holding short. He's doing the same thing this time from an alternate angle. And it does seem like NaVi knows something's up. Look at the rotations. Like, Simple's responsible for doors now. They've already tucked a bit back into B. And he's ready for a reactionary incendiary.
We might get Simple versus Searson at mid doors here. Keto is actually the one ahead of the pack. Hinge smoke about to be dropped here. You have to be quite quick about how you do that these days. Now working on this short control, and they will get it for free right now. Tabson is on his lonesome. Simple's actually going to be setting up the boost with the electronics. So, look, they're going to be in the wrong place. It's going to be a B pounce.
Yeah, Big have actually faked out NaVi again. Bit. This has got to be a stunning set of double kills from you, mate. Perfecto, he's delivered one.
Oh, needed that.
Does get the second, even a dink into Gade. He's kept it relatively competitive, but I'm not sure NaVi want to go for this. They'd love to contest in our ninth round of play. They're floating towards the doors. It's not like they're not going to have a look. Kit's present, couple of flashbangs, a resmoke on the doors. Does shave a little bit too much time off of that clock. Oh, we heard the pin. Boomich knows there's one close car. NaVi are going to walk through on the flash. Gade booked. Searson, big box, and he's down two. They have to be getting a wriggle on. Tabson's coming from behind.
Electronic has the kit.
Yeah, and Boomich spots him out. They get the kit. They get the defuser. Lovely B retake, a late one at that. Not often you get to see that pay off.
Yeah, it looked like they were almost let in there for a second, right? It was fantastic in terms of, hey, who's going to clear what? Boomage going straight and glued to the left-hand side of those doors. The fact that Searson is just pinned towards the big box, he can't contribute anything whatsoever. So a great little retake here. We'll check it out from Boomage's POV. Runs on in. Good spacing, good pathing from everybody there. They're not grouped up. They can't get multi-fragged. And a great retake. You don't see a B retake coming in too often. So it wasn't a save round, everybody.
I was flabbergasted when I saw that
they were going for it.
He pushed it through the smoke.
Boomich giving himself a lot of room here to work with at long, getting onto the other side of the doors. It's early info too. That molly, when it subsides, Big will be able to hear these jumps, and while those bullets are noted by Boomich as well.
Well, he's just a brave boy, isn't he? Hey, might go again. You wouldn't go again, you naughty boy. Boomich wants info. Now he's dropping smoke. He could get pushed through. Oh. Dude, their flash was perfect. Like, if they chose to, he would have been a dead man.
We sent them packing, right? They're not going to knock on that door. That smoke is up for another, 10 seconds from now. Starting their jaunt down middle here.
Probably the least enviable position for a CT to have to play is this uncertain CT role. I mean, when there's nothing, there's nothing. When there's something, there's usually everything. Flashes, smokes, and an entire T side. Tabson's trying to keep the pressure up on long, and oh my lordy lord. That's more than pressure. Just a, like that, a flurry of frags across the map. That's great. Good catch from our Ops team as well. You can see the reaction immediately upon the arrival of the frag from Long. Electronic with his pants around his ankles and his knife out.
Well, Tom Perfecto, they're coming to his bombsite here, and he's out of position to spam. Not good enough to convert anything whatsoever. Damage done to Gate, a little bit to Keto, and now it's just simple. Tizian will take him down too, and a huge round from Tizian. Just strolling out mid off of that contact on Long, takes two down, and really sets big up for their fifth. So great stuff there to respond and to break the bank of NaVi here going into the next round of play. You thought it was too good from Boomich towards Long early, but Tabson on his lonesome in-game leader on in-game leader action.
I mean, just from the initial 10 rounds, like Big Clan have locked down any sort of attempts through that mid doors. But like I said, Big Clan, the way in which they've been doing their T side pressure has usually left mid as a bit of a second thought.
Yeah, if you can push simple around the map, so his AWP is having to be a supportive element for somebody else, then it means he can't impact when you're going for those mid to Bs or you're going for those cat takes when he's somewhere else. So he's down again already. This is looking good for the sixth round for Big. And this would be a huge scalp to take for Big.
I mean, yeah, this would be huge for their project of taking top three as well.
The group is still quite open at the moment here. I think Yanko was talking about NaVi and FaZe, you know, being the cream. Well, not the cream. The two are at the top of the group so far, right? Yeah. So if we just continue with form as we had right now, those two, let's say that they get through in one and two, or at least guarantee the top three. And then it's probably between Mouse Sports, Fnatic, and Big. So that's why for Big, this could be a huge result.
Yeah, I mean, you've got two games left. One is NaVi, one is Mouse. I think you'd want to take both Ws if you wanted to be competitive for that Group C top three. They're coming for you.
Easy peasy. Okay, cleaned up. Six now. And this is where NaVi are the ones who are either going to continue to do more of the same. All right, guys, let's just keep doing this default CT setup, or they might go for a mix-up. They might throw a bit more of an aggressive maneuver. Now, it's not that they're throwing, they haven't been throwing different moves. They definitely have, just none of them are completely out of the box just yet. So I'm talking about something unorthodox. Now you can see the big boot camp. Sirison, he's with them. He wasn't with them.
He's arrived.
No, he's there now.
He's not got his bloody dongle on his webcam.
The 5G router that he borrowed from a mate. Imagine a pro gamer
Not having good internet.
Yeah. In 2021.
And yet, I swear, like 10 years ago, people you were playing with had two internet lines just in case one went down.
Yeah.
Back in the day.
You got to be ready. Okay, well, looks like they're postured for this B setup again. Boomich has all the info over towards Long. Electronic and simple duoed over towards A, but it's the B hit one more time. Here we go. Nade's coming through.
Perfecto, don't forget, you got 2.5 with a FAMAS and now equipped with the M4. He's caught a very early Keto and Bit. Oh, the element of surprise. He stands to deliver another. They know Perfecto was in B. Surely they'll clear him. They're looking the wrong way. And Big Clan get absolutely demolished on their arrival to the B site.
A little bit confuzzling right there that they weren't ready for Perfecto over towards Carr as well, considering he got that kill from Tallbox. How many places could he have gone? Either slips out the doors really, really quickly, or he's Carr with bits. So maybe communication for Big there being all over the shop. But that is the NaVi response, and it wasn't through anything unorthodox. It was just through two players locking down that B side. So standing the test over towards B.
Dude, they've got a Krieg on CT side. Back in the day, that was a real threat.
It was a treat.
It was a real treat. And there are some positions I'm sure that it will bang. Perfecto, you can just sit at that B box, sit way back plat.
Double AWP as well here. So Bits brought out his secondary.
Simple knows what Searson's up to, right? Like, I think the we've seen him play like End of Suicide, Lower Tons. His responsibility early on the default is short and simple. He's like willing to take that fight. He's hoping someone gets a bit pushy or they try and boost Searson up for the fight. So he's hanging out in that little off angle just under the lip of potential engagement. Three members floating towards Boomich's Long smoke, and it looks like they do want to go and clear that out.
Boomich has to be very careful here. He's already considered one death towards Long. That the chain reaction that was set off was a NaVi round loss. And he's just on the corner, so ideally spot and fall, Boomich.
Come on now, what's he supposed to do? He does manage to find a frag, a one for one, certainly competitive and simple, called to action. Can he stop the pit drop? The answer is no. Is Short covered? The answer is also no. Electronic's going to have to be responsible for that. Lots of util drop towards Simple's location. Oh, he needs a safe haven. He's got a little bit of a gap. And a missed shot out of Simple. He won't get a second chance onto Keto. Bomb now loose, and Big Clan looking a little worse for wear. Still, big frag out of Gade here. Big frag out of Gade, but Perfecto's Krieg too sharp. And now the bomb lost long, and Searson just doesn't have the time to contribute. He's just going to be hanging out looking to save.
Yeah, it'd be lucky if they dropped into his line of sight here. Perfecto's about to call short. Clear Simple's been locking down long, just playing behind the smoke, and well, this one is done. So seven now for NaVi. And Searson was doing what we're talking about with patrolling and covering off those rotations. He just couldn't find all the impact he needed. Boomich, the fact he's hung around and he's got a kill there, like the smoke on the corner, you have to feel for him. The reason he's playing around it is for info. He's playing for info.
So it's not a pure fake, he has to know.
Yeah. And the fact he gets one means that it's definitely justified. If he didn't get one, but he got the info, probably not worth it. But the fact that he gets that info, gets the kill, it's almost more time here. Round number 14 getting underway. Now, it's back towards this B hit. They're just trundling through Upper Dark and very noisy about this as well. If they're expecting the double orb setup in play again, which it is, they could overrun Bit here. That could be name of the game. It's tucked in towards Window in a timely manner. And they're slinking out the doors.
Okay, mid to B smoke is there, and Bit, he's going to be the element of surprise. Ooh, they jiggle it perfectly. I can't believe he's gone for a re-peek there. He's lucky to be alive. And Big are coming.
They're in trouble.
They're coming in thick and fast. A boost might help, but they're already knocking on the B door, and Electronic with one. It's Keto that takes the site for Big Clan, though. A double entry. Tizzy into plant. And yeah, NaVi are going to have to save all of their schmeckles. So that's quite the response. After two real flat dud T rounds, Big Clan on the ropes, recover with a, you know, a higgledy-piggledy buy.
Yeah, and it's worked out greatly for them. You know, I think they just identified what CT setup NaVi are likely to run with again. I understand if they can quickly flash that AWP back off the line, they're able to scurry over towards that B bombsite, close the distance. It all comes down to Perfecto. And you were talking about that Krieg. Sure, it's great if they want to fight you one at a time from Upper Dark, or if you're posted out the doors looking down to mid. But when you're getting swarmed, right, that fire rate can become a bit of a problem here. Can't be here, there, and everywhere like you would with an M4A4. Bomb goes off, tie things back up at 7-7.
Here's an alternative pitch for you.
Here we go.
So you know how you were like, we were having like a debate about M4 and M4A1 and why you should, you know, shouldn't necessarily be able to choose between them from the same buy menu? Mm. And you were talking about committing to something before the game. What about you could choose between the Org and the M4A1 and the Krieg, you know, as like an alternate to the AK?
Okay.
They're both there.
But the prices would obviously have to be as they are.
Like, as in you choose whether you have the Org to fall back on or the M4A1.
Okay.
Prior to starting.
Yeah, that's curious.
That's not bad. Tabson, that's not bad either. Oh, and he sticks around for the greed. Boomich wanted info. He catches way more than he bargained for. And, you know, I felt like 9-6 after those first two barrels spotted. Seriously, and that's...
Doesn't need to hit the shot.
Yeah, I guess it was just to make sure Electronic wasn't ready for the Keto frag.
I think Big are going to take this one.
Yeah, I was calling 9-6 when I saw those rounds fall apart.
It's going to be 8-7 here. Big is setting himself up. Very pretty here for the second half of play. This is their map choice. It is just Perfecto to find right now, and he only has a Deagle.
Bang. Lovely stuff out of Keto. Urukai, perhaps.
An Urukai. Okay.
Now then, CTE4, Big Clan, they're on the defense, and they did manage to have a real solid T haul, so they've given themselves a one round buffer. We'll see if the pistol goes their way. That'll start to become all the more telling as to whether or not Big Clan will stay competitive up against NaVi. You can see one expert still leans the way of the black and yellow. I think most people watching anticipate the same. But Big Clan definitely demonstrating an ability here, an affinity to compete. Now, the long commit, it is
a classic at this point.
A bit of a classic.
We've seen a lot of it in that first half, seen a lot of it from NaVi.
But it now hinges on the Perfecto and Bit rolls.
Now, Perfecto, oof. On LAN, I remember he had a round where he did exactly that but got three kills, and he was very poised. This time round, he's dead as a doorknob. Now they're going straight across long as expected. Two HEs. We saw that out of NaVi profit.
Yo, but Bit is going... I mean, Keto should have him. That's the reason he exists. A nice attempt at the flank, but cut short. And Big Clan, they've crossed their T's, they've dotted their I's, and nothing much more for Simple Electronic to do about this one. Yeah, an armored P250 does not get Simple far.
Yeah, nothing.
Yeah.
Just the plant. Not any kills, no extra $300 bonuses going on through. I think for the P250, it's one way that the Ts can level up the field against the CTs with the USP. It's also still bloody hard, right? So those USPs, very, very deadly.
USP.
Now let's see, do we get the Na'Vi force by coming out the gates for round number two here in this second half? Or we see something a little bit more conservative. So a great one there from Tabson. First bullet out of the pistol. For both of those players right there. Keto doing the same. Crispy, crispy one-taps. The point-and-click adventure of the USP. Just about breathing, guys. Just stay calm, put your crosshair on their head, and click.
So you get, yeah, late armor purchase out a bit. We will get two AKs in play. Electronic dropping one for a bit. Perfecto set up by Boomich. Simple, an armored scout. This is a threatening buy from Na'Vi.
Similar to Biggs, right? But they had an extra Galil in the mix. I think that came through the kills that they were able to get, right? So there's little difference makers. Can be reflected in the buy quite heavily. If they just take short control here, they can execute onto the A side. The biggest gun they have to get past, well, is Tabson with an MP9. Sirison helping with his scout. And we've already seen him on the T half hit some great shots on retaking CTs. Now, as a defending CT against the Ts, this is the more normal type duel. Mm. But here we go. They're just going out before the nades. They're straight out.
Sirison greets him with a smile. That nade looks great. Very brutal for Na'Vi. Where has their health gone? Look at this, they're forced to extinguish it. They're going to have to surely get turntail and run.
Find that second AK if you can.
Yeah, you try your best. This could cost Simple a great deal, and now he's up against that scout from Sirison. He is on notice. A wallbang could put him down, but he does tap the Sirison head. Sirison needs a whole lot, excuse me, Simple needs a whole lot more of that.
Get that bomb down if you can here, Bit.
Bit? What is he doing? He wants to take an aggressive stance, and it's just led Tabson to another. Multiple targets, just the tip of the head is all Keto needs, and call it 10. Big Clan passed the test of the Na'Vi force.
Oh dear, all right. Well, they tried to play ahead of the smokes and flashes there, Na'Vi, catching the A defenders off guard, because if they're playing a smoke molly defense of their own, they're waiting for the util, then they lob out their own, but they managed to get it off in time. And look at this, Sirison didn't get caught off guard, able to hit two shots as they're coming out there. Great stuff from him. Almost dispels them immediately here, and then the combination of utility slows them on down. They make it into the site, but they're battered and bruised. And we're going to call that 10 for Big now. It should even be the 11th. Just these light upgraded pistols, P250s, Deagle, Tech 9. Couple of smokes and a flash. Na'Vi would have to pull off something quite spectacular here to hurt Big.
That's not out of their wheelhouse, champ. So they know there's a scout mid. I'm sure it'd be tempting to try and isolate them. You can see Electronic's gone for a way downtown smoke grenade. Similar to how Big Clan were doing their mid to Bs, and that's a cancel, I think. CT. Oh.
Goodbye. That's the bomb.
Lost
might
the
need
bomb,
that.
Actually, yeah, roasted up. Bit of a hazard having the bomb so close to those flames.
Yeah, how did it not explode?
I don't know. I think the health department's going to be really upset about that.
The health department?
Yeah, the safety inspectors of Dust2.
All right, yeah, they come through.
It's at night, you know. I mean, you haven't seen Dust2 at night, but they have.
We could just have night dust too. People do some very good stuff. They change the skies.
They do. The skybox.
Get some floodlights in there.
Don't tell anyone, but I used to play with a modded skybox when I competed in COD.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Made the sky as bright blue as possible so I could see the nades in the sky.
Get the Call of Duty police out here.
I mean, give them a ring.
Lauren would be so disappointed in you.
Yeah. And I used the web next bind. That's right. To cancel my reloads. Scum.
I used to use stop sound in 1.6.
There you go. It's good. It's a safe space. It's good to get it out. I can still remember the command, the little script you type in.
Well, the guns are out for Na'Vi here, and this map, I don't think it's gotten away from them by any means, but they're going to need one on the board soon. Sirison flashed, AWP strikes, Bit is down.
Two pretty frustrating deaths back to back for Bit.
Yeah, and they've even got four players over towards this A bomb site right now, Big. Look, Tabson's in CT, I'm aware, but he can get over real quick.
Yeah, Sisson's going for like re-sweeps, re-clears. He'll peek off the flash. That sounds like a good cue to post up. One across, certainly possible, and that's Boomich. isolated from his squad now as the smoke comes in. It implies a re-aggress, so he tucks in for potential aggressive maneuvers. Now, we're at that 45-second mark, Chad. And
yeah, real problems now.
Getting awkward. Oh, they can't even leave. They want to go towards the doors, and Keto's the one that does deny initially. He took a big headshot into Electronic, which does soften him up for the taps and wall bang. And that was a 2v4. I really don't fancy their chances here. Boomich and Perfecto in a bit of a dire strait.
You want to say save, but not even that's possible, I don't think.
Yeah, Searson tested by Boomich. He's begging for a frag onto the A site. And using those smokes to close the gap.
I think Tizian's won the round here. I know this is going on. It's a big fight on A, but Tizian's in T-spawn.
Yeah, unless he doesn't
finish. Oh, he's going to make it.
Job.
Wait, he's going to make it. The fact that it was the MP9, I didn't even click on that. Okay, they will get the bomb down.
They will, with 1 second to spare.
Quickly now, Perfecto.
1 second to spare. Yeah, he's got it down. Gade CT, Tizian mid. Oh.
And what Boomich a turnaround!
This is a Boomich round, exclusively. He walks in on the Searson AWP, and now suddenly a roll reversed. It's Tizian, and he's just got to walk through the smoke. Great shot out of Tizian. Oh, he can come up clutch, and he does with the spray. Oh my God, NaVi did so much right. Tizian's just better.
Oh my Lord.
He
I thought he had won the round
smoke.
With the push in T-spawn. It was the second push that gets him the round. Huge stuff from Tizian there. I can't believe it, but the fact that any of those events happened, it didn't feel like it should have gone down that way.
Okay, guys, let's all take a breath and let's use this replay package to put it together again. So this frag onto Searson, nuts. 14 seconds, then Perfecto doesn't get finished off, brings the bomb.
Get one here, they can rattle that economy. Going for a four-man A lean one more time. Keto to solo B during all of this. Pressure applied long, Gade, Tabson, and Tizian to respond, but they will call this one clear.
Good start for Big Clan. Nade down the gullet. Electronic forced off of his Long Doors project.
Run boost and a flash. Well timed. Searson this time not getting away with an opening kill. So they've been able to garner this short control and keep the 5v5 alive.
Early as well. You've got so much time to play with already denying that info from the CT. Simple. This is where I see some of his best work. He can post up on this. Let's see how well-trained Gade is. He's now back to the tier one realms. Let's see if he's already got it well-drilled. When he gets smoked off, what's his reaction? Plays around it, a flash to relocate, and
ooh,
it does seem to be a one-on-one right now. In the smoke, he lingers. Just flirting with the edge of that smoke. Keto called upon Gade. Wow, wow, Gade gets the frag. Lives on, Keto caught on the B rotate.
They know B's clear
they
now,
do.
Though.
If Perfecto just runs in knife out, it might even be a save.
Oh, Tizian's pushing long again here. Yeah. Boomich needs to go now.
And he will. Doesn't know he's vulnerable and finished off by the Tizian flank. So they've got the B site. A B retake asked of them. And yeah, shot fired from Simple confirms that the B site is on lock. Nice split of the resources. Tabson from window, Tizian from the tons. Molly isolates.
Oh,
and
he trusted the Molly too much.
He completely did, and Simple asked to clutch. Look how far away Searson is. If Tizian doesn't get this frag, I don't know if Searson's even going for it. Now he's starting to come out of his hidey hole. He's left his roost, and Simple knows what's up. I don't know if this barrel's been spotted. I suspect it has. And loud there from Searson, the crawl from Tizian. Sharp bait to the sharp. Big Clan say play on. 13, a retake into the B site.
Ooh-wee, all right. Just fumbled that one right there. Perfecto, I think he thought the Molly was enough to keep Tabson away, but playing ahead of it, able to be extremely annoying. That gave away not a free kill, but an early kill on that B site. And then it's just Simple left in a usually unwinnable scenario. I think the only reason most of us at home are believing in this is because it was the man himself.
Help me understand that Molotov you're talking about. So did he throw it from door side and then went window?
No, he threw it through the window, yeah. But the thing was it was too deep. So Tabson was still able to jump up on the little ledge and throw that grenade down and apply some pressure. It's hard. The window molly's hard, right? Because a lot of players, when you go into the Gambit's the only one
Since
who can
June,
topple them, right? Yeah.
Against anyone other than Gambit.
Yeah.
Like that's...
Yeah, you're okay with that.
So if Big Clan come in and break that streak, they're on a 9-match win streak, including Gambit. 9-match win streak for NaVi. So this Big Clan, if they wanted to complete that and break NaVi in that respect, post their first loss of Group C, it would be a compulsory dust too. Now, Electronic is ahead of the Long Smoke, so there's a bonus for NaVi. They got some intel.
Well, they have to be careful about this AWP again. Oh, nade
more
down.
More nade damage.
Yeah, just being chipped and chunked away. And look at this. They want to fight doors here. Very active stuff here from Big. Tizian's been great. Tizian's been fantastic on this CT side. Look at him go.
He gets both of them on his own.
They're floundering right now, NaVi. They can't seem to find a solution for this. Big are just so active, right? They're actually taking the fight to NaVi. They're not just giving them the respect to take the side control, go for those executes. Tizian doesn't have a lot of kills. It must almost all of his impact has come in this half, right?
Yeah, it must be a stunning second half. Looking at utility damage, credit has to be to Tabson. He's already done 300 utility damage, 200 for Gade. Those nades here on the second half have been stacking up nicely. Good find. Perfecto does deal with that Tizian short player. Electronic onto Searson does give us a competitive one. Bomb planted. Perfecto opting for ramp side, so nothing in the initial swing here from Tabson. But he just goes hunting, and again he finds the head. So aggressive. Tabson calls it 14. NaVi just can't seem to catch a break here. The German's just too strong in these mid-rounds.
It's the confidence, right? They're clearly playing with confidence. They're not being scared in taking these fights. And they're more than happy to go for aggressive maneuvers. And that is just netting them these jewels that NaVi don't look ready for time and time again.
That
look at this push behind the molly. They were also applying pressure mid-doors. That is fantastic from Tizian to get two. Yeah, they trade out efficiently. They get them into the site. They get the bomb down. We'll see another NaVi buy for sure, but rattled right now and running out of responses here. Go for the all-in long play. Just operating now with the standard default spread. Simple with the Krieg. Has to make loot with that of the AWP that he cannot afford. Electronic long, Boomage, Palm Tree, Perfecto on bit through the tunnels. And Big, well, they're just doing a standard setup here. Tabson is floating around mid-doors early this time round, so I think they feel like they've bought enough of a buffer to short just with that Searson presence there quite frequently.
And I talked about Tabson's utility damage and how he's the top of the scoreboard, but just seeing the nerdy lineup he has for the lower tons walk-up is promising. NaVi have avoided that for now, and Tizian surely going to have to give up on long. He doesn't have the info. He doesn't have the info. Is he just dry peeking for the clear? And yeah, okay, that one is NaVi's all day long.
Need to be careful. Searson's top A with the AWP.
Yeah, he could do a lot of damage here, and he's already got one from the scope rifle of Tabson. Oof, big find. AK works wonders.
Oh, he's in no man's land.
He just reloads in front of them. All simple. Does find it, but it seems like Big Clan are still kicking up a fuss. Throw the bomb across or get there as best you can. A quick incendiary to buy time. And he's got what has he got? The smoke for the cross, a little bit of a one-way action.
Nade as well.
Bomb has been planted. Cade starts his crawl. Simple knows exactly where you're coming from. More nade damage. Simple, this is great from Simple. A quick execution of the first. Keto's lost him around the smoke. A multi-kill still on the menu. Never mind. Simple's Krieg looking good today. Three from Simple as he does to keep NaVi at least with their head above water.
Well, that is their first T-sided round so far. You know, since we've switched on over, the score was 8-7 in favor of Big. They've been able to get six consecutive rounds out the gate here. That's going to take a lot of hard work from NaVi to even get them back in the conversation for this map.
Yeah, and I don't think they can count on a Tizian, as they say in League, a face check.
Okay.
I don't think they'll count on a Tizian long face check.
Good. Yeah, okay. I think I know that term.
Yeah.
You can count on this, though. Running up mid with USPs, you can really count on this.
Right? There's nothing to get worried about. Right?
I'm pretty worried right now if I'm a NaVi fan.
Oh, dear. Now, that's the bomb, right?
Minute 30, both the CTs are in spawn.
And they've got a Krieg and powerful headshot angles.
Boomich only has a Mach 10 coming in for this. Tizian's not looking right now. He can catch him off guard. The blind side, he needs to be careful.
I love the gap. He's managed to kind of...
Oh, Tizian.
Get within that Mach 10 range. Oh, they know where the last is now. This should be the NaVi soul. Okay, well, Blade puts his belt back on. Everyone can relax a little bit.
That almost got wildly out of control. They just trusted Searson's scout, which got a kill up middle, and then just flooded up.
Catapulted them up.
That's some crazy level Counter-Strike here. So this is the opener. Oh, dearie me. The headshot onto Bit, and then just flooding on up with these USPs. Lucky Simple gets two, but eventually they're too much. Boomage, very active. And put that together with Perfecto here. They do close this one down in style. Simple, okay. He didn't like how last round went. See you later, Gade.
You really don't want to make Simple angry. Citizen's looking for info here on the tons. I imagine he's not going to full commit to this. He looks like he might. Oh, Perfecto dancing in the off angle. Still says and thrives. Very quick. It shouldn't translate into much more, though.
Yeah, just go A right now. There's an AWP over towards B. It's just pistols on this A site.
Oh, more
Keto
Tizian.
Falls.
More Tizian action. Oh, he had his opportunity. Flub smoke, but that forces him out of the line. And Searson's AWP to be saved. If they didn't smoke, he might have had something to say. And
looked like he was tracking
yeah,
there for
it
a second, didn't it?
I think he's just got a perfect read of how that smoke crosses the most likely pace of the T.
One of the keys here that I just want to talk about and why the scoreline could be sitting at 14-9, about to be 14-10, is it's not simple they've really kept a lid on. He has 21 kills. It's Electronic and Bit. Those two combined only with 18.
Truth.
Now, those individuals play some key roles on that CT side, and as well on this T side, you're going to be looking for Electronic to find you that creepy, beaky long territory and Bit to find you some entry frags that he takes short control. So they've been a little bit lacking in that department, but not dead yet.
That's not an easy shot to hit by any stretch. Level one zoom. Simple the Hunter has delivered an AWP for Big Plan, and I don't think he'll retrieve it. Tizian eliminated and Simple's AWP saved. Okay, NaVi starting the difficult project of recovering from a very strong Big Clan posting.
Now, these two rounds were still had an element of scariness about them, right? Because the Scout and then the AWP of Searson, right? So now we get to see the full guns come in, and this is where Big really would just like to close down any conversation about a comeback, right? Tapson, unfortunately, only has an MP9. The rest are into the rifles.
Yeah, force the rebuy out of Searson, though, so this will completely evacuate the coffers. They're going to have nothing left. Ooh!
That's what we need from Bit.
Yeah, and that's a Tapson frag gone already. Re-peak Searson, aggressive. I think they thought he dropped off. They were trying to take some space, and it's not the play. B is wide open for the taking, and Perfecto dispatched to have a look. Oh boy, oh boy. Simple has to hold down this rotate, but he's got the bomb on his back. They smoke it off, so they can return to the fray. Gade with a deep clear confirms mid-doors is still under CT rule.
It's like a tortoise race right now. Nobody wants to make any footsteps, right? So whoever has the goal to get towards that B bomb site first might win this round. Gade staying parked towards the B double doors, and it looks like bigger gambling, right? If it's a mid to B or if it's an A hit, they've got the lion's share of their forces there. But if it's a B attack, it should just be the safe call. Smoke out for the mid to B. Gade can be the difference maker here if he gets two.
Kept a lid on it.
And that should really be it, because if you're Big, you're risking a lot here to go for this. Unless you get gifted a freebie, somebody not being careful around the smokes, you might just let NaVi have this 11. They're starting to take a bit of territory. Look at the radar in your top left. You can see Keto was clearing out top mid. The rest of his teammates, well, they look like they wanted to join him, but it will be that save call. Now, in the next round of play, the loss bonus is going to be 2,900 for Big. Right, this is a situation where they could have another buy behind these rifles. You can get some drop famuses. You could invest into yourself lightly. Right, you've got two options here. You can either fully invest and get everybody the best you can, or everybody in the next round, you get a deagle on Tabs and a deagle on Gade, Searson, Keto, and Tizian, don't spend a penny. And then that way, if the max loss bonus in the round to come after that, everybody will be able to buy, right? So you get like half the players with rifles and then everybody with rifles.
I like that option more.
Yeah.
I like that option. But when you're on 14 and you're in pursuit of two more rounds, I don't know. I think I'd rather keep it conservative. NaVi's gap is closing quick. It wasn't that long ago. We saw them post their first two rounds. Well, now they're posting four in a row. Not for lack of trying. This was Gade. Had it been a double, as Chad highlighted, they may have given it a good look in. But when a big frag from the traded death of Electronic, you were highlighting him, and yeah, he's still been very quiet as a product of the CT's performance as opposed to necessarily just him. 14.
Just yet, so Big.
They nearly lost to USPs, Chad. They could easily lose to three rifles.
Precisely. Now, it's going to be a bit of a mid boost setup here. The NOA stack in play. Haven't seen this one for a while.
Oh boy, and he's got vision.
Hello, Governor.
Electronic, another nasty death for him to concede. Even the wallbang is threatening. Perfecto thinks better of it. They're pushing him. Tucks in, wide from Tabson. There's so many bodies on to push, and now weapons are lost. The site perhaps as well. Keto, good spray.
Can't die here.
He really can't afford to die, and even the incendiary's perfect. They're playing retake on this one. Bigger a threat, a very big one. Simple's walking into the,
not clearing.
The party. Yeah, can't even snap into that one. It looks like Big Clan are finding 15 here. If they can convert, I don't see a kit, but that's not really going to make a world of change.
31 HP. Yeah. No hope.
No hope at all. Boomage would need a tap. They're already up on the site, and it's easy as that. Big Clan, with a couple of pistols, we'll leave with some AKs and a 15th. That is a dream. It looks like Na'Vi's Dust 2 could be falling a little short of the mark here.
Yeah, they're getting rumbled right now. They get this loss bonus of 1,400. The plant's good too. Gives them that little buffer of cash here to be competitive for what could be the final round of play, round number 26. Make that round number 27. The maths ain't on point right here, right now.
Yeah, I mean, don't forget as well, there's been a large break since the officials of Big Clan's last Dust 2. They took the player break, and we've only seen two of them so far. 100% win rate since the start of the new season for Big Clan so far.
New player, too.
So. New player, precisely, yeah. Fnatic and EG are the only full five-man Big Clan results.
Well, Gate's been tagged here by Simple's AWP on the cross immediately, so that's a good start here for Na'Vi, but they can only take us to overtime now. Last round, it looked like Big had a pretty good idea of the tendencies of Na'Vi with that NOA boost punish.
Yeah, right. Now, Electronic was just staring at the floor.
They need to push Sirison back without a casualty here on shore, and they've struggled to do so, and he gets another one. Oh, dear, it's all falling apart now. Simple down, Boomage down. Could be all over.
Certainly. Electronic might not even clear his corners. Oh, my Lord. Big Clan have got these boys dead to rights. There's just no gaps. No gaps at all. Can't keep their jewels, and it's been a while since I saw Electronic and Bit looking human. Like looking like, you know, flesh and blood.
Yeah, they've been kept very, very honest in this one right here. Look, there's a minute on the clock. If we want to look towards the positives, they both have the majority of their HP. They have a couple of nades to work with. And if they want to hit this B bomb site, they have to get through Keto and the softened up Gade from Simple's AWP early. If they get into the B bomb site and don't lose a player, maybe.
You've got to be brave. Perfecto's so tagged on the walk up, and yeah, he's down. Keto, the final frag from him, perhaps? Yeah, call it.